Yeah, sometimes I have to apologize for the video game industry for going for the lowest possible common denominator for their game titles. Take Exhibit A for example, Balls, 3D or 3D Balls. Get it? Yeah, so this is supposed to be a revolutionary 3D fighting game that consists of sprites that are all ball related and they can zoom in and out with the greatest of ease. And it's a one-on-one fighting game. Unlike that stupid Virtual Fighter 2 on the Sega Genesis, yeah, this is fully 3D. So there's a good chance that this might be good. And there's a good chance it won't. Okay, let's review it and find out. Yeah! Let's go ballistic on these balls. Woo! Yeah, so we had to become good enough to fight this guy, the Jester. Yeah, so we get 8 different characters to pick from. Yeah, a caveman, a clown, a giant muscle dude, a really quick guy. Yeah, a sumo wrestler. It's so generic. Now, if they would add like some 2D artwork so we can at least get an idea what the characters look like, then maybe you can have some interest in what you're actually playing as. But no, you're just playing as little cylinder spears. It's boring. And once you get used to the controls, it's not too bad. But it's so hard to judge the perspective of the characters. The 3D in Soul Calibur works a whole lot better. There you had the option of going to like an alternate stick or control pad to do the 8-way run. Here you're forced to do it and it just feels very awkward. Yeah, so this is definitely a clusterfuck, holy shit. It's hard to tell, you know, what hits are actually connected. Especially in this awkward 3D environment. Yeah, the problem with the game is that it's so hard to figure out what the hell is going on. Like Turbo here, he's the blue one over to the left. Yeah, he's hitting me with some invisible shots. Here, I went for attack. But, you know, all that Ostrich had to do was stand still. If you thought the new Taylor Swift album was pretty bad, wait till you listen to this. Yeah, and I hope you like that music too, because you're gonna be hearing it a lot. Yeah, the music is terrible. It's cool when you first play for the first time, you see your enemy actually disintegrate. That's kind of cool. And it has a unique 3D perspective, but it certainly does get old after a while, like holy shit. Yeah, so I know a little history behind this game. Yeah, this was supposed to be one of the first online games you can play for Sega Genesis, but then they realized it was a piece of shit and decided to release it as its own Sega Genesis game. And when you have all these balls lined up together, it loses a lot of the personality that something like a Street Fighter or Mortal Kombat would have. Yes, it has more of a 3D element to it and, you know, you can almost praise it for that. But you can't praise it for its very generic and lackluster gameplay. Yeah, just imagine the worst 3D game on the Sony PlayStation and Sega Saturn. And then, yeah, you get something like Balls 3D. Very rudimentary gameplay. Pretty much rudimentary everything. It might be kind of advanced for a Sega Genesis, but the gameplay doesn't hold up at all. When it's all said and done, 3D Balls is just that, complete and utter balls. It sucks. It sucks major balls. You definitely don't want these balls in your face. Yeah, it's balls to play. The graphics are balls. The soundtrack is balls. Everything is just balls about this game. Pretty Balls. Yeah, it earns a 34 out of 100. Definitely don't grab these canes by the balls. I'm sorry, I'll stop with the balls joke. But it's a Gaines fault. It's a fucking Gaines fault for even giving it that name to begin with. Holy shit. And that's it for me. This is Herzog, world champion, feeling quite ashamed of himself. Over and out. Get that fucking thing out of here.